you know, it's incalculable. Well, it is calculable, but it's gigantic.
All right, everybody. Welcome to the channel. Can You Do Any Better Investing? Part of the Can You Do Any Better Network. This is an educational channel. We talk about all things investing. If you enjoy our videos, please smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel, and you can ring the bell to get notifications so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. I am Tom. I am not a financial advisor, and this is not financial advice. And today, I would like to talk to you about a company named Marathon Digital Holdings, stock ticker MARA, M-A-R-A. So, I'm very excited to do this video. I've been waiting a while. This is a Bitcoin mining company, and this is a sector that I think is wildly misunderstood. The numbers are not what people think. In the least confusing way possible, I would like to try to describe what Marathon does and what their numbers look like, because it's not what people think. So, having said that, let's dive into it. Here's Marathon. It's trading at $29.19 midday here, down a little bit. So its market cap is $2.9 billion. So this is a small company. It's, from a market cap standpoint, I think the second largest company out of all the North American miners. Marathon Digital Holding announces Bitcoin production and mining operation updates for June 2021. I just want to hit the highlights. They produced 265.6 new minted Bitcoins during June of 2021, increasing total Bitcoin holdings to approximately 5,784. So they have coming up on, you know, maybe by the end of next month, they're going to have 6,000 Bitcoin that they're holding. So that's number one. Increased active mining fleet to approximately 19,395 miners, generating approximately 2.09 exahash. Okay, I'm going to start this story by going to the fourth quarter 2020 financial results. My point in all this is I want to show where they came from and where they're going, because as people look at revenue and PE ratios, I don't think everybody understands the drastic changes this company is going through. So, you know, you can throw a lot of these numbers when you try to put a PE ratio to it, it's irrelevant because their growth rate is so astronomical. It's almost like nothing I've ever seen. Total revenue increased 854% to $2.6 million from $0.3 million in the fourth quarter of 2019. So in 2019 fourth quarter, you know, that's a year and a half ago now, they were at $300,000 revenue for the quarter. So insignificant, basically at zero, not really even in operations. So by the time they got to the fourth quarter of 2020, 854% growth rate. These are the kinds of numbers you're going to see throughout this discussion. So, you know, that puts you in an entirely different league. 854% growth rate, you are a different company than you were the year before. So it becomes non-comparative. So now that gets them to $2.6 million. But here's the thing, that 854% growth rate, they hadn't even gotten started yet. Bitmain ships 4,000 Antminers to Marathon Patent Group. Marathon's current mining fleet consists of 2,560 miners, generating 248 petahash. So that's 248 petahash per second, which is 0.248 exahash. We just looked at the June update. They are now doing 2.09 exahash. So, you know, not quite a 10x, but that's another 700 or 800% increase. So they had an 854% increase year over year from 2019 to 2020. Now they've had, you know, almost a 10x increase in the hash rate, which is the rate at which they mine Bitcoin, in the first half of the year 2021. This is a schedule of their projected hash rate. This is from the investor package. So this is internally generated by them. So in the fourth quarter of 2020, the big thing that this company did is they basically got purchase orders in and full commitments for what is going to take them from, we saw they were at about 2,000 machines. They have orders to get them up to 103,000 machines. As a result of that, their hash rate is going to increase astronomically. So now if you flip to June, they were expecting to be, there's 2,000. In June, they were expecting to be at about
2,000 petahash, which is 2 exahash, and they just reported they're at 2.09 exahash. So they're tracking along this line. So you can see that from this small line to this line is massive growth, but it's the smallest part of what they're going to do. If they can stay on this production schedule, then by the first quarter of 2021, they're going to be at 10.37 exahash. Their computing power to mine Bitcoin is gone up mind-boggling. Again, they were at about 190 petahash, and they're going to go to 10.37 exahash. You know, it's incalculable. Well, it is calculable, but it's gigantic. It's astronomical. Okay, so here's a quick chart I made. I just, you know, this column is estimates. I don't have a crystal ball. I don't know that that's what they're going to do. This is from their own investor package, so take it for what it's worth. But so far, they have been tracking according to that schedule that we just looked at. What I've done here is talked hash rate and Bitcoin's mined. So in February of 2021, we saw that their hash rate was 248 petahash or 0.248 exahash. Well, they mined 43.4 Bitcoin in February of 2021. June of 2021, so I put July 1st here, but really these are the June numbers, they went from 0.248 to 2.09 exahash. So that was a 743% increase in their hash rate. But more importantly, because this is real money, they went from 43.4 Bitcoins mined to 265.6 Bitcoins mined. That is a 512% increase in the number of Bitcoin they mined. And that is just from February to June. So that's just a few months later. Estimate at 3/1/2022. So this is Q1 2022, once they get all their machines in. Like we talked about, they're estimating 10.37 exahash. That's over a 4,000% increase from February of 2021 to March of 2022. That's basically 1 year, a 4,000% increase. But again, more importantly, they're anticipating mining about 1,650 Bitcoins in that period of time. Now, there's a lot of variables that go into that, so we can't be sure exactly what they're going to mine. But if they stay on track, taking this for what it's worth, that would be a 3,700% increase in Bitcoins mined. So that's a one-to-one correlation to revenue. So that's over a 3,700% increase in revenue. And remember, last year they had an 854% increase in year-over-year revenue. One of the things that everybody always says, one of the negatives to investing in these Bitcoin miners is, well, you know, depending on the price of Bitcoin, energy costs a lot of money and it may not be worth mining Bitcoin. Well, that argument used to be true. But that argument was true when Bitcoin was at $3,000 or $5,000 or even $10,000. Bitcoin, as I sit here today, is somewhere around $34,000, which is way off of its high of $64,000. Here's some projections that they went through. So they're looking at 121 Bitcoins a day. This is based on the current worldwide hash rate, which I will tell you has come way down and is likely, you know, over the course of the next year, maybe to return back to where it was. At the current worldwide hash rate, they would be producing 121 Bitcoin a day. The current price of Bitcoin was at $33,990. So you can see the $34,000 Bitcoin and a $2,000 cost, you've got an awful lot of room in the middle. So, you know, all this talk about the price of energy and the price of Bitcoin, yes, does it affect their gross profit? It sure does. But when you're talking about 2,000 versus 34,000, let's say the worldwide hash rate was to double. If that was the case, then theoretically the cost per Bitcoin would double. So that would make it $4,000 energy cost per Bitcoin. Well, again, even at 30,000 a Bitcoin, that's a grand slam home run. You're talking over 80% gross profit. And forget at 60,000 or 100,000, you know, the gross profit margins are not what people think. So the giant conversation surrounding this and all the massive volatility in the price of these Bitcoin miners stock, you know, when Bitcoin ticks up a couple thousand or down a couple thousand, as you look at these numbers right here, you'll see there's no sense to that. The gross profit margin at $34,000 of Bitcoin is not that different than the gross profit margin at $30,000 of Bitcoin or at $40,000 of Bitcoin. At all of those numbers, Bitcoin mining companies are wildly profitable. This is just a quick chart I put together of some revenue benchmarks. So in Q4 of 2019, we talked about how they had $300,000 in revenue. In Q4 of 2020, and we looked at that press release, they had $2.6 million in revenue. Well, from the fourth quarter of 2020 to the first quarter of 2021, they increased their revenue to $9.2 million. That's a 254% increase. These are actual numbers. So that's a this was a 767% increase year over year. This is a 254% increase quarter over quarter. And again, this is revenue. This is not Bitcoin generated. This is actual revenue. Their projection for the first quarter of 2022 is $102,950,000 of revenue. That's another 1,000% increase in revenue. At 90% gross profit margin, that's $90 million of gross profit in the first quarter of next year. This is not a technical analysis video, so I'm not going to get into a lot of the lines that I've drawn here, but you will see this stock was already up at around $58 back in April. It's now hanging around $29 or $30. Just to get back to where it was, this stock needs to double. To me, and again, I don't have a crystal ball. I can't project the future. This is not financial advice. I could actually see my projection would be that they get to their old highs, they break through their old highs, and sometime my price target for the next 12 to 18 months is $100. And I could easily see this company in the next 5 years going to $300. That would be a 10x. Those are some things that I think that could happen with this stock. So let me know what you guys think. I will do more videos on Bitcoin miners and Bitcoin to come. So thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, smash the like button, and we will see you in the next video.